and sit thee down upon this flowery bed, while I do coy thy amiable cheeks and stick musk roses in thy sleek, smooth head and kiss thy fair, large ears, my gentle joy.
Where's Monsieur Cobweb? Ready? Scratch my head, Monsieur Cobweb. And good Monsieur, get you your weapons in your hand and kill me a red-hipped humblebee on the top of a thistle. And good Monsieur, bring me the honey bag. Do not fret yourself too much in the action, Monsieur. And good Monsieur, have a care the honey bag break not. I would be loath to have you overflow with a honey bag, Senor. Where's Monsieur Mustard Seed?
Ready.
Give me your neef, good Monsieur. Pray you leave your courtesy, good Monsieur.
What's your will?
Nothing, good Monsieur, but to help Cavalieri Cobweb to scratch. I must to the barbers, Monsieur, for methinks I am marvelous hairy about the face. And as I am such a tender ass, if my hair do but tickle me, I must scratch.
What? Wilt thou hear some music, my love?
I have a reasonable good ear in music. Let's have the tongs and the bones.
Or say, sweet love, what thou would like to eat.
Truly a peck of provender. I could munch your good dry oats. Methinks I have a great desire to a bottle of hay. Good hay, sweet hay, hath no fellow.
I have a venture, Sterry, that shall seek thee the squirrel's hoard, and fetch thee new nuts.
I'd rather have a handful or two of dried peas. And I pray you, let none of your people stir me. I have an exposition of sleep come upon me.
Sleep thou, and I will wind thee in my arms. Fairies, be gone, and be always away. So doth the woodbine, the sweet honeysuckle gently entwist, the female ivy so in rings the barky fingers of the elm. Oh, how I love thee. How I dote on thee.
Thank you.
two nights watched with you, but can perceive no truth in your report. When was it she last walked?
Since his majesty went into the field, I have seen her rise from her bed, throw her nightgown upon her, unlock the closet, take forth paper, fold it, write upon it, read it, afterwards seal it, and again return to bed. Yet all this while in a most fast sleep.
A great perturbation in nature. To receive at once the benefit of sleep and do the effects of watching. In this slumber and agitation, besides her walking and other actual performances, what at any time have you heard her say?
That, sir, which I will not report after her.
You may to me, and 'tis most meet you should.
Neither to you nor anyone, having no witness to confirm my speech. Lo you, here she comes. This is her very guise, and upon my life, fast asleep. Observe her, stand close. How came she by that light? Why, it stood by her. She has a light by her continually, 'tis her command.
Are open.
Aye, but their sense is shut.
What is it she does now? Look how she rubs her hands.
It is an accustomed action with her to seem thus washing her hands. I have known her to continue in this for a quarter of an hour.
Yet, here is a spot. Time to do it. Hell is murky. Why then? Fie, my lord, a soldier and a feared. What need we fear? Who knows it? No, when none can call our power to account. Yet, who'd have thought that old man to have so much blood in him?
Do you mark that?
The Thane of Fife had a wife. Where is she now? What, will these hands ne'er be clean? No more of that, my lord. No more of that. You will mar all by this starting.
Go to, go to. You have known what you should not.
She has spoke what she should not, I am sure of that. Heaven knows what she has known.
Yet here's the smell of the blood still. All the perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this.
Heart is sorely charged.
I would not have such a heart in my bosom for the dignity of the whole body.
Well, well, well.
Pray God it be so.
This disease is beyond my practice.
Wash your hands. Put on your nightgown. Look not so pale, I tell you yet again. Banquo is dead, he cannot come out on his grave.
Even so?
There is a knocking at the gate. Come, 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 come. Give me your hand. Come. To bed. To bed. To bed. Thank you.
Thank you.